Alright everyone, welcome back to Cody's Lab. As you can see, I'm back in the city and have been shoveling off the porch because a lot of snow had accumulated while I was gone. Unfortunately though, the mailman and the religious solicitors had really packed it down, so it's been really difficult to remove the packed snow from the porch, and this is about as far as I've gotten. So, I think this is an excellent opportunity to try something out that I've always wanted to do, and that is to melt the ice using sugar. That's right. I got a table sugar. Let's see if I can melt the ice with it.
I don't just want to use sugar for the curiosity, but also because salt really is damaging my bushes here. It's also the grass is really salt damaged right around here as we try to melt all the snow with the salt. But sugar would not damage the plants. So what I've got set up here is a little experiment I'm going to try. On one side of this porch area, I'm going to add 4 pounds of rock salt. And on the other side, I'm going to add 4 pounds of granulated sugar. And then I'm going to compare the two. All right, so on this side of the porch, I'm going to put rock salt, and on this side, I'm going to use the sugar. So this will be pretty sweet, I think, yeah? You see, us lazy humans use rock salt to help melt the ice, because the salt, as it dissolves into the water, lowers the melting point of the water and makes it so it'll melt off, so we don't have to spend a lot of time actually digging the ice off of the road surface. And I'm no exception here. All right. So there's the last of the salt. So this side's salty and this side's sweet. Very nice. Looks like both have actually already started working. You can see the salt is beginning to melt the ice. It's starting to look wet now, but the sugar's doing the same thing. You see over here. So yeah, looks like it's working. So it's the next day, and as you can see, most of the ice is indeed melted. Here's the side with the salt, and here's the side with the sugar. The sugar side actually has a little bit of ice still left. So that would mean that the salt did better. But honestly, this side probably was a little bit more packed down than the other side because it was right in front of the door. One thing I would like to point out is there actually is still salt here though. Most of the salt did not get used up. Most of the salt is still right where I left it because it didn't take very much salt to melt the ice, whereas all of the sugar's gone. All of the sugar's run off the porch. You see that the water's basically run off. This is because the sugar has a much less melting capability than the salt does. Also, the salt was a little bit more granular, so maybe if I had really giant chunks of sugar, there'd still be sugar left there. But then I'd bet there'd be less ice melted as well. Even though there was the same mass of salt as sugar. The thing about the salt, though, is it's 58 grams per mole, where sugar is like 340-something grams per mole. So there was much less moles of sugar. There's much less sugar molecules than there was salt molecules. And it's actually the number of molecules that does the melting work for you. Because in order for the water to dissolve the salt or sugar or whatever, it needs to actually bind to it. It needs to have an electrostatic attraction to it. And if the water is attracted to another particle, then it's basically that spot on the water molecule is now taken up that it can't attract to another water molecule. Because it's actually the attraction of the water molecules that causes them to combine and then stick together and turn into a crystal. Sugar, because it has much less particles for the same amount of mass, it was able to inhibit the water less. But also the salt had an extra benefit of being able to break into two particles while it's dissolved, whereas sugar does not do that. And so the salt has an even better chance of melting the ice. But still, I think that's pretty cool because now my bush here is probably going to be much less affected, this bush. So it might be interesting actually to see which bush does better. But unfortunately, I can't do this experiment like multiple times. Like I can't do a whole year of putting sugar on the porch because, well, let me show you. Hear that? It's sticky. The floor is sticky. So when I walk in, I got sugar on my boots. And sugar is sticky. This is definitely probably worse than salt, and is likely the final nail in the coffin of using sugar to melt ice, because Canyon hates it. You see, sugar's pretty hydroscopic, so it actually holds onto the water better than the salt does. You can see this side's almost dry, whereas this is still wet. Very difficult to remove the water from the sugar, whereas salt just gets rid of it very easily. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you next time.